It's been 3 years since everything happened at the Baker House. I was looking for my wife, who disappeared. I got an email from her. She told me to come get her. And of course, that's how I ended up in the middle of nowhere, Louisiana. I found Mia being held captive in a dark basement. She wasn't thinking right. She attacked me like some kind of wild animal. Later on, I found out that she was infected by a special kind of mold. I looked all over the house trying to find an antidote, a vaccine, anything. The people who lived there were already infected. What was left of them wasn't human. The source of the infection was a bioweapon that looked like a little girl. Her name was Evelyn. I fought the fucked up family and was able to treat Mia's symptoms with a serum. Then Chris Redfield and his soldier buddies showed up and saved the both of us. Is that enough? I really don't want to talk about what happened anymore. It's all over now.
Long ago, a young girl went with her mother to pick berries for her father, who was hard at work. But the forest greeted them with a dark, cold silence, the bushes empty. Yet determined to find the berries, the rascal broke free from mother's grasp and vanished into the trees. Mother's worried cries faded fast as the girl ran on, over vine and under branch, and into the forest deep. Feeling strange eyes upon her, the girl recalled mother's scary bedtime tales, and her throat became bone dry. Then the Bat Lord appeared. He greeted her warmly and bit his own wing. "Come, child, quench your thirst," he said. So she drank the thick, dark blood and smiled with joy. Passing through the graveyard, menacing storm clouds loomed, and the air turned bitingly cold. The girl was shivering in her thin clothes. Then a dark weaver appeared, and with a click of his fingers, crafted mist into a beautiful dress. "Come, child, warm yourself," he coaxed. So she clothed herself and smiled with joy. Across waters deep and ominous she went, hoping a boat she found would carry her home. But hunger's grip tightened and her heart grew heavy. Then the Fish King appeared and offered one of his many fins. "Come, child, eat your fill." So the girl ate and smiled with joy once more. Continuing on, she soon entered the forest's dark heart. Then an iron steed appeared, bearing a beautiful golden gear. The creature said nothing as the girl approached and snatched what she thought was another gift. The horse grew angry and summoned the other monsters. Terror filled the girl's heart as the wild wind rose around the beasts. Suddenly, a witch appeared, dark, yet regal. "Gifts we gave, but more you took," she snarled. "So more in turn is due." In a blink, was trapped inside of me. There. She's asleep.
What is with the creepy story? She's only 6 months old.
Woman at the store said it was traditional. A local tale. Besides, Rose doesn't seem to mind.
Because because she doesn't understand it. Thank God. We moved here so that she wouldn't have to deal with any of that, remember?
There's nothing wrong with my memory.
You're just being paranoid.
It's not... Never mind. I'm sorry. But I'm not paranoid. I'm just cautious.
Nothing.
Almost there, honey. There you go, sweetheart. Don't you worry. I'll be right downstairs. Daddy won't let those weird fairy tale monsters get you.
Is she okay?
Sleeping like a baby. Smells good. What's that?
Oh, hands off, mister. It's churba de legume. It's a local recipe.
Wow, you've gone full native, haven't you?
Local wine, too. But if you're gonna keep sulking all evening, maybe you shouldn't have any. You really have to stop worrying.
It's just finding you in Louisiana. Pregnancy, Chris moving us here, military training, it all happened so fast, you know?
Well, at least we're all together. You, me, Rose. Now, everything's gonna
Seriously, think we can just forget about what happened in Louisiana?
It happened so long ago. I don't understand why you are so...
Mia, get down! Mia! Mia. Oh, God. Chris? What the hell?
Sorry.
What? Why?
Go move.
All clear.
Rose? What the hell are you doing with my daughter?
Package secure, sir.
Take him away.
I said get your hands off her!
Ethan, no.
Rose.
Get him.
Hey, Doc.
Hello, Mr. Winters. I've got your daughter's results back, and I'd like you to come in to talk about them. How about next Thursday, 4 o'clock?
No problem. We'll be there. That was the Doc. She'll see us next week.
Hey, now. Think positively, all right? We talked about this.
I know. It'd be hard. hardly talk about anything else. I keep telling you, it's not Rose that I'm worried about.
Well, then what are you worried about? Look, she's gonna be fine. I just know it. What else matters?
We matter, Ethan! You matter! You just
Mia, what are you talking about? Is there something you're not telling me? Come on, talk to me. Damn it. I have to take this. Where's Chris Redfield? And Rose?
Who is this? This is a secure channel. You are not authorized to walk over.
Fuck. What the hell happened to you? Thank you.
Pag may, di ba lang kapag may ano kayo, pag nagbakuna kayo, mayroon kang pamilya mo?
Mm-hmm.
Sino yung ano mo? Ilang well, pamilya?
Ayaw nila.
Ako. Puno lang.
Ha?
Puno lang.
Ikaw?
Oo. Oh.
Sige, try ko bukas. Kasi...
Ayaw nila?
Oo.
Sino yung mga auntie ko? Kasi ayaw nila, mami. Astronika? Kailan ba sa'yo? Tagal pa?
Hmm.
Ha, ako lang ha?
Ha?
Kasa amin, taekwondo rin eh. Bakuna daw. Na-referee. Ha?
Ha?
Ano yun? Mama, papa mo lang, gano'n? Ano?
Mga katirahan.
Ah, tirahan kasama sa bahay?
Oo.
Ah, di, ako na lang. Lagay mo. Nag-sign ka na?
Hindi pa.
Ah, lagay mo ako, ha?
Pa?
Hindi, aralas. Ha? Ang pagamutan, ha?
Pa, pa.
Ano, taekwondo? Luto na.
Okay, okay, okay.
Ha?
Sige.
Baka ko si Prince ng Buwana. Be? Baka nang mawak mo? Baka nang tutulas. Kung baka nang lalan. Be? Ay, hindi rin mo yung lagat na yan. Ay! Ano yan? Bili yung ano, daga? Kalaban niya? Kalaban daga, ano?
Who did all this?
Hindi ba yung mga daga may explode yun eh?
Thank you.
Friendly! Friendly!
Who are you? Who sent you?
Nobody. There was an accident down on the road. What's going on?
Oh no. They're coming.
Who is? What the hell was that?
You have a gun?
What?
Please tell me you have a gun.
No, why would I?
Take it! Take it! Help me, it's out there.
Hey, are you listening?
Hey!
Thank you. Wait. Wait.
Shouldn't be out here. It's not safe. What the hell? Hey, can you hear me?
It's you, the child's father.
Child? Hey, wait. Do you mean Rose? Is she here?
Rose! Rose, yes. She is in great danger. Since Mother Miranda brought her to the village, we have fallen into darkness.
What are you talking about? The monsters?
Harold's danger. They're coming.
No. Wait. Where's Rose? Who's Mother Miranda?
The bell tolls for us all. They're coming again.
Rose is here? Okay, I'm not gonna hurt you. I'm just glad to see normal people at last. Have you seen any other survivors?
No. They're all in Louise's house. And she's not answering, and the gate is locked.
Quiet, girl. It's an...
Oh. Shit, we're sitting ducks in here. Can your old man walk?
No. One of the monsters cut him. He's lost a lot of blood. We have to get into Louise's house.
Shh! Quiet! Must be a way inside. Stay here. Be quiet. And don't move until I get those gates open.
Huh?
Come on, it's clear.
Hurry, hurry.
Took your damn time.
You're welcome.
He's not used to relying on other people. I'm sorry. We'll be safe in here, won't we?
Safer here than out there, that's for sure. Hey, do you know anything about what's going on around here?
It doesn't make any sense. Mother Miranda has always protected us.
Nobody's answer.
Father? We have to get inside.
Hello? Anybody home?
Maybe a familiar voice. Louisa! Open up! It's me, Elena!
Stop shouting. You'll draw the monsters.
Julian,
calm down. Who's this?
A friend.
Stay back.
Father, for God's sake, Julian, let us in.
No, they'll smell the blood. You'll endanger us all.
My father will die out here.
That's not my problem.
What's going on?
These people want to let a dying man into our home.
Come now, these people are our friends. Go on, go inside. Come now, this way. You're not from this village.
No. I'm Ethan.
Julian, go make yourself useful and check the grounds. I said go! Well, if Elena trusts you, then so do I. Come inside, Ethan. Wait here. I'll check on the others.
Inside, the others are waiting.
What the fuck is this? Outsiders, you're gonna get us all killed!
Quiet! Anton! He helped Leonardo and Elena.
We were doing fine by ourselves.
Please, Ethan, take a seat.
Is this all that's left? From your entire village?
What's left? All that's left? There is no one left! A worthless... invalid, a stupid, wailing bitch, and you drag a bloody man and an outsider in here like it's nothing, and expect to be all safe? There is no safe! Every sorry bastard out there has been ripped in half. But tomorrow we're all... just like her damn husband. Put a sock in him, Roxanna!
That's enough! This house has protected my family for generations. And drunk or not, you are all welcome and safe in here.
Whatever.
Can someone please tell me what the hell is going on here?
We don't know. One day we were a quiet, devout village, and the next, the monsters came and attacked us. And they kept coming.
Wait, Louisa, where is your husband? Did they...
No. No, he is out there. Somewhere. He went to get help. Yes, that's it. He went to fetch help.
Let us pray. For him. For all of us.
Good idea. Come.
What the fuck are you doing?
Leonardo, what's wrong? Are you okay?
No!
Father!
Elena, no, stay back!
No, Louisa! No! Oh my God. I'm so sorry, Father.
Hey, that wasn't your father anymore. You did the right thing. Elena, no. There's nothing you can do.
Papa!
This entire place is collapsing.
No!
You couldn't save him. He was already gone.
Leave me alone.
No. We're getting out of here. Together. We gotta get out of here.
Back. We can bust out with this.
Back up again.
The fire. There isn't any time.
Nowhere to go but up. Grandpa, hurry. Let's move.
Don't worry. I'll try not to breathe in the smoke.
I know. Thank you, Ethan. Kind. I hope your family is safe.
I do too. Once we get out of here, maybe you'll get to meet them. Come on, it'll hold. There, that's our way out.
Thank God. But what then? We can't fight them. There's too many.
Hey, don't talk like that. We'll find a safe house to put you in until I can find my daughter. My hunch is she's in that old castle.
No. That place is full of nothing but blood and death. And I don't want to be alone while you're... Father?
Elena, no. That's not him. Not anymore.
He said my name. Father!
Wait, it's not safe. Stay there! Come on! Give me your hand!
Ethan, go! Save your daughter!
Elena, don't give up! Reach for me! God damn it!
Why is everyone dying on me?
Yes, death has visited them all.
nothing but blood and death.
Anyone was left. You must be pretty tough, huh?
Who the fuck are you?
Oh, you're not local. Even better. Mother Miranda's gonna love you. You're whining. We're almost there.
The man is of no real use to anyone else.
And my daughters do so love entertaining fools.
Furthermore, I can assure you to entrust the mortal to House Dimitrescu. My daughters and I shall deliver to you the finest.
Ugly, I want to see. He's awake!
Don't you shut the fuck up!
What? Where?
You mean you'll screw around with him in private, and where's the fun in that? Give him to me, and I'll put on a show that everybody can enjoy.
Oh, so gauche. What do we care for bread and circuses? The man thinks suffering is assured.
Yak, yak, if a man's dick is cut off in the castle, blah, blah, blah.
I've heard all your arguments. Some of you were less persuasive than others, but I've made my decision. Heisenberg, the man's fate is in your hands.
Mother Miranda, I must protest. Heisenberg is but a child, and his devotion to you is questionable. Give the mortal to me, and I will ensure he is ready.
Shut your damn hole! And don't be a sore loser! Or else.
Quiet now, child. Adults are talking.
I'm the child. You're the one who's arguing with Miranda's decision.
You wouldn't know responsibility if it was welded to
that. Oh, keep drawing. One day your head might actually fit your ego.
Fight, don't I get a say in this?
Silence!
My decision is final. Remember from whence you came.
Thank you. Lycans and gentlemen, we thank you for waiting. And now let the games begin.
Let's see what you're doing. Ethan Winters.
Get ready. No, wait! Ten. Nine. Eight. Seven. Six. Five, four, three, two, one, showtime!
That's right. Run for your life. Very nice, Ethan.
Shit!
word. You truly are as strong as they say. Oh, you don't think I'd let you get away. Gotta keep Donner and Moreau entertained. So now it's time for the beautiful, blood-soaked grand finale. Nothing like fresh American ground beef!
Too close.
Wait, do those freaks have Rose?
I've been waiting for you, Mr. Winters.
How do you know my name?
Anyone who is anyone is a hero searching for his daughter. Though I must say, that castle arouses suspicion.
Yeah, and so do you.
I am but a humble merchant.
Here?
Oh, forgive my manners. Call me the Duke. Now to business. Weapons, ammunition, healing salves, anything you desire, I can provide. Shall I choose something? I have something special today. Securing goods is more important than anything. Anything, my friend. Why you'd be interested in that. What are you buying? Just something an old friend of mine used to say. Please come again.
Be here.
Hey, she needs to figure herself out, okay? You know she's still got a lot of Man blood. Mother, I bring you fresh prey.
You are so kind to me, Doris. Now, let's take a look at him. Well, well, Ethan Winters. You escaped my little brother's idiot games, did you? Let's see how special you are.
Yes, Mother.
Yes, Mother. Starting to go a little stale.
Then let's devour his man flesh quickly, Mother.
But I am the one who captured him.
Now, now, daughters. First, I must inform Mother Miranda. But later, well, there will be enough for everyone. Udama! Oh, be careful what you wish for, Ethan Winters.
Wait, what are you doing?
We meet again.
Duke, why are you here?
Where there's coin to be made. And have you found your daughter?
No.
If she is truly here, the lady of the castle would have kept little Rose in her private chambers, would she not?
Domitresque?
The very same. Why don't you take a look? Maybe you'll get lucky. And speaking of looking, care to make a purchase?